and it's Godot.
Hello! We know many of you guys like Godot, and we do too, but there are legitimate reasons not to use the engine. And we want you to make an informed decision when you go and look into an engine. You know, part one came out a while ago, so we had time to find some good ones. So here are five possible reasons for you not to use Godot. And we will finally have time to talk about our first little controversy.
It's related to boobies, so you might be interested.
Okay, let's start with a big one.
Number one, it does not offer console exports. And this is for quite a strange reason. From how I understand this, console exports would need a lot of interactions for proprietary stuff, like the console manufacturer's SDKs. There are non-disclosure agreements involved, etc. So the export templates could not be open source, because Sony, Microsoft and Nintendo would simply not allow this. These would need to be released separately or something. Another problem is that only companies can develop for consoles, and Godot is an open source project, not a company. So is all hope lost? Generally speaking, looking at the world right now, maybe it is. But looking at your Godot game on the Switch, no. There are different publishers offering to fill that gap, and you likely would need publisher support anyway for a console release. There are different options for Switch, PlayStation and Xbox. For the Switch, Godot.io has quite a nice offer without any upfront cost, and we'll link two more in the description.
Number two, the asset and plugin ecosystem. So like, there isn't really one. Don't get me wrong, there are ways to get assets when using Godot. First of all, many assets are engine independent, so you can use those. There's also an official Godot asset library, but all of those assets must be free, which sounds great at first. But people tend to offer assets for a reason, and this reason is money. So the amount of assets is not comparable to the Unity asset store. There are a few sites like GodotMarketplace.com, GodotAssets.org or GodotAssets.io, but they also don't really seem to be there just yet. I mean, look at that. There are like two pages here, and this one is mostly the free assets from the official library. And there are a few reasons why Godot's asset ecosystem might stay weak. Compared to Unity, Godot's user base is just smaller, which means there is less demand, and this directly means fewer sales for the asset creators. It is just much more profitable to offer Unity-specific assets compared to Godot-specific assets. There's also a cultural difference. Godot is free open source software, and many users love it for that. This is why there are many great resources for free, but the downside is a little less acceptance for paid stuff, just as a general vibe in the community. I don't think it's a stretch to say the average Godot user is less willing to buy assets than the average Unity user.
Number 3. It does not have the best 3D performance out there. Some people say you cannot make 3D games in Godot. This is a gross over-exaggeration. But that's what people on the internet do, right? But there is a little bit of truth behind that claim. First of all, yes, there are high hopes behind Godot 4 making 3D rendering much more modern. But it is not done yet. Godot 4 is still in alpha right now and needs quite a few improvements. So who knows when it will be stable and how good it will really be. What we have right now and what people refer to when they say Godot 3D is bad is version 3. And in these regards, a bunch of cool stuff has been added, including occlusion culling. But honestly, have you seen Unreal? Unreal Engine 5 looks incredible. It's just astonishing, the infinite detail with nanite and all these things. I do not have experience in Unreal, but it seems like the choice to make if you want to go with AAA looking realistic rendering. And Godot 3 is far away from that, and likely Godot 4 will be far away from that. You can of course make good looking 3D games in Godot, even realistic ones, but it's not the engine's strength. Luckily, this isn't really a problem for 2D games and stylized 3D games.
Number 4, the branding.
So this one is personal. We will get to that. Let us do a little experiment.
Let's look at some engine logos and see which one sticks out. This is of course not entirely fair, but there are arguments to be made against the way Godot presents itself. And we will use the logo as an example. The community brings up the branding discussion from time to time, but there does not really seem to be any will to listen to this as I see it. The best thing we got was an April Fool's joke, rebranding the engine to Godette Engine. Godette is a Godot mascot character. The community then started to produce a number of icon suggestions, but nothing really seemed to come out of it. So what's the problem? The logo seems to be quite polarizing. Some people love it, and others find it too childish. And this seems like an irrelevant detail, but an ugly or uncool logo can turn people away. It's also about the signal it sends. It gives out friendly vibes for sure, but does it seem like something you can develop commercial games with for a living? Maybe a little bit less than the other alternatives. Still, the logo is not up to discussion at all. Fun fact, technically, you would need to give attribution to Andrea Calabro every time you show the logo, as it is licensed under CC BY and she's the creator. We tried to be a little playful with the mascot and made a bikini Godette version because...
Well, mainly because I wanted to design a Godot bikini.
We needed an appealing image to pixelate for our pixelation shader tutorial. And we were met with our biggest controversy yet. We got a response from one of Godot's main developers, analyzing how much area of her breast is covered, which quickly was edited to something more reasonable. And it sparked a discussion thread by a now deleted user. We link both of these threads in the description. But still, it shows a certain kind of prudeness that also seems to extend to the Discord. It is a difficult question what kind of space the Godot community should be. There is such a wide range of games, some almost exclusively enjoyed by children. But there are also adult games, covering adult themes, like boobies. In the discussion thread, there was an argument about whether bikini artworks belong in a work setting, if the good old Reddit even is a work setting. And this is difficult, because for people working on not safe for work games, it totally is. For others, it is not. And it seems difficult to build a welcoming space for all these people and games.
What do you think about this? Let us know in the comments.
Number 5. The tutorial situation. For many developers, video tutorials are the most important way to learn something new, or the most important way to copy-paste code and have a new feature. And within the Unity ecosystem, there are 15 videos of people who did exactly what you needed. For Godot, on the other hand, there are a few people. They do amazing work. I mean, we try our best to add tutorials each week. There are many other channels, like all of these. But overall, the workflow of typing in what you need and finding it does not work right now. We all try our best to make more stuff, but this will need community growth and time. On the bright side, it protects you from tutorial hell, so there's that.
So okay guys, what have we learned from all of this? A game engine is a tool, and there are different tools for different jobs. A AAA developer might not need the same engine as a solo dev, and a 2D dev might not need the same engine as a 3D dev. There is no best engine, so find the one that suits you the best. Apart from that, this whole video is of course just our opinion, do not take it as consensus. We are just two people with a fish microphone. You are allowed to disagree. Actually, we would encourage you to disagree down in the comments. What are problems we have not touched? With which points do you agree? Keep in mind that a lot of progress is made in all of these things. Also, we love Godot and it is an amazing tool for indie devs. If you have not seen the video on why you should use it, click this flying magic box here. Whoa. Godot.